What's up guys, Serpent Torque here. Today's video, I'm gonna give you the best M16 loadout in Warzone. We're gonna be using the Black Ops Cold War variant of the M16. Real fast before we start, make sure you leave a like if this helps you out at any point during the video. And if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. We are so close to 1,000 subs. And if you guys can help me get there, I'd be so happy. I have a lot more Warzone content coming out, so make sure you stay tuned to the channel. That being said, let's get into the video. First attachment we're going to be putting on the M16 from Black Ops Cold War is going to be the muzzle. The muzzle we're going to be going with is going to be the infantry compensator. The pros here are going to be vertical recoil control, which is going to be very important on a burst weapon. And then the cons are going to be horizontal recoil control, which in my opinion, I don't think is that bad. Next attachment we're going to be shooting for is going to be a barrel, which is going to be the 20.5-inch task force. You're going to get a lot of pros on this one. You're going to get damage, effective damage range, and bullet velocity. The only cons for this one are going to be vertical recoil control and horizontal recoil control, which I believe we're going to be getting back in a couple other attachments. The third attachment for this gun is going to be an optic. This is kind of all preference, but if you're playing Warzone, a lot of people like using it three times. So I'm going to be using the Seal Arms three times, but you can kind of put whatever you want on this one. I recommend a three times for Warzone. And then from there, we're going to be choosing the underbarrel, which is going to be the Field Agent foregrip. It's going to bring you back those vertical recoil control and horizontal recoil control we lost earlier. Shooting move speed is a con on this one, but I don't think that it's going to harm me that much. The fifth and final attachment on the M16, we're going to choose the ammunition slot, and we're going to be using the Salvo 60 round fast mag. The only con here is you're going to lose aim down sight time, but for the pros, you're going to gain magazine ammo capacity, reload quickness, max starting ammo, and ammo capacity overall. So this is one of the best mags, I would say, for this gun. Not only do you have a lot of ammo, but you reload faster. That's really one of the best benefits you could have on this gun. Other than that, that's pretty much it for this one. Make sure you stay tuned. I have the rest of this gameplay of me using the M16 in Warzone. I technically am using it in Plunder just because it's easier to show off the gun because you spawn with it if you die. But hope you enjoy. Make sure you leave a like if you haven't already. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. A lot more Warzone content coming. I still have zombies content coming and multiplayer content coming on the way. Gonna be covering a bunch of stuff with all new season one content in Call of Duty, Black Ops, Cold War, and Warzone. So make sure you stay tuned to the channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.
UAV overhead. Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the skies. Enemy cluster strike incoming.
Check fire! Come on, man!
Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the sky!
got movement.
Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the skies. Attack chopper is in the AO. Bring it down and recover the cash. Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the sky.